To today's edition of From the Eagle's Nest. It is Thursday, May 21st. Waxwing, how about a quick warm-up?
Ooh, hello, viewers. How's everyone doing today? You know, yesterday there was such beautiful weather. I was sitting out on my porch relaxing, and then I see this poor guy walk by, and he spilled all the Scrabble letters in the middle of the road. I walked over to him, and I'm like, hey, what's the word on the street? He just looked at me really odd. I don't know, poor guy. You know, you know what? Speaking of the word on the street, let's head to some squawk talk for all of our viewers.
Okay.
Yellowhammer, over to you.
All right, and I am going to hand it right over to Hawkeye. She's got a new contest for us all.
All right, kids, as you know, Memorial Day is next week, and we are announcing our patriotic pet competition. We are going to have a little pet show on our show next Tuesday.
Ooh.
Our top 10 pet entries. So send us pictures of your pets looking as patriotic as possible. And here's the information where to send your slide. One important thing to remember, Yellowhammer, for the kids?
Well, one thing that we have to remember is it has to be just pictures of your pets. As you can see, we don't have students on our show, and that's because of all the crazy laws and everything that's out there that we can mention our kids by initials, but we can't show pictures and have them on. So we're going to make sure it's your pets. And I'd love to see a little American flag doggy walking by or something. That would be very cute.
That's right. It'd be a lot of fun, guys. We're looking forward to those pictures.
Yeah, I am super excited to see those pictures. You know, once my dog also ate some Scrabble tiles, and he kept leaving me messages all around the house for days.
Oh, that's one crazy dog.
I don't think I can get any more lame or cheesy, but that's all right.
Yeah, you can.
I can?
I'm sure you can.
I don't know why I keep getting off topic or anything, but you know what? That reminds me, speaking of being off topic and having a bird brain, right?
Yeah.
Let's take it away to Yellowhammer with bird brain trivia and weather from the nest.
All right. Well, I am actually going to start with the weather because we are so lucky. We're going to have a few really good days. We're going to have sunshine, and then it's going to be a touch rainy over the weekend. And then next week, I saw 80 in the forecast. 80! Now, our friends, kids, we really need you to keep doing your homework, okay? So even though it's nice, go out, get your walk in, and then come right back and get some stuff done early in the morning so you can spend the afternoon outside playing or just getting some fresh air. So, which leads me to the trivia, or my bird brain trivia. This is my little turkey guy. I thought he was cute. So this is about crickets. Mrs. Webster, I know you like to camp, so maybe you can do this late one night while you're camping. Crickets, a cricket chirps can tell the weather. So when you hear a little cricket, they can tell the weather. You count the number of chirps in 14 seconds, just like you would do your pulse, but for 14 seconds, hear the chirp, and then add 40, and that is the approximate temperature.
Wow.
Who knew?
That was good info.
And because you know, once we get comments and people start liking what we do, of course, we got to elaborate. So, Mrs. Michaels, your son said they liked Shelby's poop joke. So, today, we've got another. And this one cracks me up. Okay, so, what do you call a vegetarian with diarrhea?
Don't know.
Okay, here it is. Salad shooter! Oh, man. I just find that hilarious. I was in tears yesterday just thinking about telling that joke.
Salad shooter.
Funny.
I love it.
Yep, so vegetarians, not too much fiber. Okay, ladies, the moment we have all been waiting for.
Yeah.
Our guest is a gaming, cat-loving gas of a guy. Welcome, Mr. Looney Lynn!
Welcome to me. Oh gosh, you're so kind. Thank you. I'm very nervous. My heart is fluttering.
Well, I was going to ask if you brought any jokes with you, but you're already on a roll. You got any more for us, Looney?
Well, you know, I think I might. I'm feeling pretty chirper today. You know, usually I charge for this, but I'm happy to do it for free. If I were a duck, though, I might send you a bill.
Lynn, I got the pleasure of hearing Mr. Lynn with all these kinds of jokes when he was in high school. He was one of my students. So we had to have him on. I know you've got some more. Keep going, Mr. Lynn.
Well, I might have a few more, but I'm going to have to do this on the fly. And Mrs. York, I remember our times together in high school like they were only yesterday. Plus, you know, a couple of years, not that many years at all.
Not many.
No, not at all.
No.
Well, I thought that since I'm a music teacher, as you are, I thought that maybe I could tell a few music jokes. And some of my students have already had to enjoy my music jokes in the past.
I bet they have. Okay, let's hear them.
Well, I've tried to find a few that that maybe they hadn't heard before. So here we go. How do you make a trumpet sound like a French horn?
Oh, I'm interested in this one, Mr. Lynn.
I don't know.
Well, you stick your hand in the bell and miss a lot of notes.
Oh! Little joke to those French horn players. Yeah, that's a tough instrument.
I'm a horn player, so I can say that too.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. What's the difference between a saxophone and a lawnmower?
Oh, I don't know.
You can tune up the lawnmower.
I think that's true about a banjo too, Mr. Lynn.
Yeah.
Well,
that was good. You know,
I'm not a saxophone player, but they deserve it anyway, so I don't feel so bad about that one. All right, let's see. What shall we do next? Oh, how many sopranos does it take to change a light bulb?
Oh, come on.
I know this one.
Oh, well, I'm sorry that this isn't a new one to you, but I'll tell you the answer anyway. It's only one, and she just stands still, and the world revolves around her.
Our little diva friends, the Sopranos.
I have a few more if you can take it.
We can take it.
Let's see. What's the difference between a viola and an onion? No one cares if you cut up the viola. Or cries and I set up.
Oh man, I thought it would be something about appeal.
Cares or cries, either way.
That's a good joke in the making, though. Something about a bell and an onion, because you know when you ring a bell, it's peeling.
Oh.
I'll work on that one for next time. What is Beethoven's favorite fruit?
Fruit.
I was gonna say baklava, but that's not a fruit.
you're close.
I wish it was.
It's a banana.
Oh! Oh!
Not a funny,
Mr. Lin.
Yeah, that is funny.
All right. Yeah. How about two more? Two more.
Here we okay.
go. Let's see. Why didn't J.S. Bach go shopping?
Because he, I know.
Go ahead. Do you want to tell it?
Because he didn't have his shopping list.
Because he was Baroque.
Well, I thought the Chopin and Liszt joke is always a good one.
Yeah, that is. I thought about that one, but I probably should have told that one because obviously it's better than most of these. All right, one more for you. How can you tell if there's a singer at your door? They can't find the key and they never know when to come in.
Oh!
Oh, snap. Yes.
Not like those flute parts in the top of the score. All right, very nice. Excellent, Mr. Lin. And you just hold on, and you have a treat for us at the end of the show.
Oh, yes, certainly.
Okay.
Well, Wrestling, don't you have a question?
Well, you know, I was going to say, like, hey, Mr. Lin, I must ask you a question, but since you had so many jokes today, I think I'll just shave my question for later.
Oh! Wow!
All right.
We're definitely going to have Mr. Looney Lin back again.
I know.
So oh. I will save them for later.
Okay.
Okay. So I guess that leaves us for the Looney Lin monologue.
Oh, you just got it.
Oh, you just got all those jokes.
I do have some today in history facts, some additional trivia, if you'd like. A few things that happened today, May 21st, in the past. One of them is very relevant to our local area, but I'll give you a couple other aeronautical ones first. Both Charles Lindbergh in 1927 and Amelia Earhart in 1932 made their transatlantic plane flights on this day. They finished them on this day.
All right.
All right.
And then the other interesting one is that this day in 1881, Clara Barton founded the American Red Cross. And of course, she established the first chapter of the American Red Cross in Mansville, New York.
Yes.
Right.
Yes, there's Clara Barton Street, if anyone ever wants to go down there. That's the place where they had the first Red Cross. Excellent information, Mr. Lin.
Nice.
All right. I'm dying to find out who guessed the career. Aikikiki, tell us all about it.
Okay, so remember we were talking about how May is Mental Health Month. And to make sure that you do things to take care of yourself. And if you do need help, the career that I was talking about was going to see a counselor, talking with someone who could help you out. And several students came up with the right answer. So I have them in my hat right here.
Ooh, okay.
Pull out a name. Well, actually, initials.
Initials.
The winner has the initials E-D.
E-D. All right.
You will be getting a gift certificate for free ice cream. Thank you for playing, everybody.
All right.
Congratulations.
Yes. Okay, back over to Yellowhammer. I've heard a rumor that some artistic feathered friends have been bringing joy to our community. Can you tell us what's going on?
Yes, I received a little surprise out on my porch. And if you can see them, we have the green screen, so it makes it hard. They're painted little rocks. One says humble and one says truth. And a lot of teachers found these out on their porch and their doorsteps And I found out that the Little Rock Fairies are our own Mrs. Forsythe and Mrs. Stevie. So we want to give them a big thank you for brightening our day.
Nice.
Okay. So here we are. Someone who rocks our world. He's going to play us a little tune on the trumpet to close out our show.
All right. Thank you.
All right. This is a Beatles tune from their 1968 double album, The Beatles, which is called Blackbird. So I hope that you all enjoy it. Thanks so much for having me on. This was a lot of fun, everybody.
Ah, thanks, Mr. Lynn.
I can't.
Slipping into the future.